Now, the first thing that we're going to do is to create a sample module, something that will allow us to work through the scaffolding of a typical module and also help illustrate the fact that if you're working within hooks, there's a lot that you can do in Drupal using the existing skills that you have that you've built working with Drupal 7 or Drupal 6. So let's head over to our resource pack. And here you should see a glue folder. You'll also see a number of other folders here, but those will be added as we progress through the series. You'll see them in the resource pack now though, so don't worry about them too much at the moment. Now let's open up our Drupal installation in a separate tab here. So now we can easily switch back and forth between our resource pack and our Drupal installation. Now in previous versions of Drupal, we would end up putting our custom modules in the Sites All Modules folder, but in Drupal 8, things get a little bit more intuitive, and now you can put modules directly in the Modules folder in the base directory of the Drupal site. So what we'll do is go to our resource pack, and we'll copy the glue folder. We'll jump over to our Drupal installation, open up the Modules folder, and paste it in. Now this folder just has a single subfolder called Steps, which if you've used Build a Module to Learn in the past, you're familiar with. The idea is that these are file stubs that we can use to copy and paste progressively as our examples start to build. So this steps folder shouldn't affect your module in any way, but this will provide us with the base code for our example as it evolves. So let's step up in our file directory structure back to our Drupal base directory. So you see we now have modules, glue, and then our steps folder. So our module is going to need two files in order to be enabled by Drupal. It needs a .info YAML file and a .module file. Now in future updates to Drupal, you may not need the .module file at all because there's legitimate reasons that a module wouldn't have that file. Typically that file will contain places where the module uses hooks. But if the module is just providing forms or plugins, those things will exist in subdirectories. So the .module file might not be necessary. For now though, we need them both. So let's create our two files, but empty for now. Okay, so here's our new file, untitled.txt, but we'll rename this glue.info.yml for YAML. And let's create our second necessary file, which will be glue.module.